Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to set up something like a fish shoal, which you can see on the screen now. So the idea of this is we use the Boids particle system and we set up some targets and move them around and play around with some of the fuzzy logic in order to get something roughly resembling some realistic fish movement. You can see here I also used the system I demonstrated in an earlier tutorial for giving the god rays or sunbeams shining through the water effect, and there's even a few little bubbles in the background and some waving weeds, which I actually did with a cloth sim. I'll demonstrate how to set those water weeds up as well. If you enjoy these tutorials, don't forget to click like and subscribe. Feel free to comment or ask questions or even dislike the video. And if you don't like the video, I'd be very interested to see what the issues you spotted were so that I can improve going forward. If you're a Patreon supporter, I do upload these files for any use available to my Patreon supporters, and I upload tutorials quite regularly. So let's start the tutorial. So to begin with, we just need to make our basic fish shape. I'm not going to make a particularly accurate one. You can do so if you want to. It all depends really on how close it's going to be to the camera. But I think I'll just start with a plane. So I've just rotated that to face the camera, and we'll go into edit mode, press E, X. And I think I'll then just bring that in. As I say, it's not going to be a really detailed model. And then same on this side, pick it out a little further, EX again, and then EX once more, and scale that up as a sort of fin. Control R, and I'll just give some more fins here. So EZ this time, scale it in, and just push it back like that. And I've added some vertices in the center there. GY, and we'll just pull that out like that. In fact, I'm going to just leave that one there for the moment. I'm just adding some more vertices. Obviously, it's up to you how you model your fish. I'm just doing this very crudely. So I've turned proportional editing on there and we'll set that to sphere, I think. You can see I'm just making half of the fish at the moment. And then I'm going to turn proportional editing off. I think I need an extra vertex there, actually. And then EY. Just give it a tiny bit of thickness there. And then in edit mode, with all the vertices selected, GY, and I want that origin point that you can see just here, right at the center point. I just turned cavity shading on there, which just makes it a bit more visible as to what's going on. And then I'm going to add a mirror modifier in the Y. And before I do that, I'm going to just apply rotation and scale. It looks like it's using the local axis, so we need it to be on Z. And then Control 2, and that will just add a subdivision surface. Perhaps we'll add a couple more vertices there. Don't want too many vertices, depending on how many fish you're planning to have. So I just used two sphere transformation there, just to round his mouth off a little bit. And we'll bring that in there, and we'll turn on clipping, just to make sure it all joins together. And obviously I could spend time making this fish more fish-like. We could even put a little fin here. I accidentally had Y mirror on there as well, which I didn't want. And set it to shade smooth. Okay, so let's just put some basic colors on the fish now. Go to preview mode and we'll say upper body, lower body and eyes. Obviously it should have a lot more materials on it than this, but I'm doing this very quickly. I'm also just going to give him an eye somewhere around there. So I'm just pressing I for inset, and then add some additional vertices and F3 to sphere, just to give him a little bit of an eye. And then I'm going to Control Plus and we'll assign eye to that. Obviously we'll make that black and we'll make it shiny. And we'll just make the inside of his mouth black as well. So I selected the whole body and I'm now going to deselect eyes, so everything with eye texture on it is removed. We'll go for upper body. We'll make this a slightly metallic color. We'll go for a sort of darkish, slightly blue color. Obviously you could put scales on it and all sorts of things. I'm just going to do this very quickly at the moment. And we'll turn roughness down quite a long way. And then we'll go to lower body, go to wireframe, again deselect eyes because there's a bit of mouth selected in there. And perhaps we'll deselect his fin as well, and then go for a fairly metallic color. We'll assign that to the lower body, slight blue color to it, but not as dark as the upper one, and turn the roughness down a bit. So there's our very fast rough fish. We'd obviously really put a texture on it, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. And we'll call him Fish. So we'll just put him off to one side somewhere. And I'm just going to add an icosphere. It's an arbitrary number of vertices, doesn't matter too much. And I'm just going to put that there. And then we're going to set up a particle system. I'm going to go for wireframe so we can see what's going on. Under particles, we'll just click plus, and you see we get particle settings appear. And I'm going to just say 200 particles for the moment. But I want them not only to start on frame one, I want them to all be emitted by frame one, which is what this means. But I also want them to last longer than the animation, so I'll just put a lifetime of 1,000 on. I'm just going to stick with the default 250 frames at the moment. So that all the particles are emitted straight away. See, they all just fall down at the moment. Then there's various things you can do. I decided to go with faces, but you can use volume as well. But I turned off even distribution just to get it a little bit more random in terms of how the particles appear. Next, under physics, we'll change that to type Boids. If I press play now, you can see they don't move quite like they did. They've actually got some sort of clumping to them. I turned on multiply mass with size, just so that there might be some variation depending on how big the fish was. But then you notice we've got these other settings down here. So under movement, I've got allow flight on. So effectively, if we want them to be swimming, they need to be flying. If you want them moving on a surface, you need to allow land, and then they'll crawl along a surface. And next, I'm just going to put in the settings. You could just start off with the defaults, but I'm just going to put in the settings that worked for me, and we'll see how they do. They'll often need tweaking anyway. So I put max airspeed at 4 and minimum airspeed I put at 0.45. Max air acceleration I put up slightly to 0.6, and maximum angular velocity I turned down a bit to 0.125. You can already see just those few changes that started to alter the way they're behaving. Air personal space I kept at 1. Battle we don't need for this simulation. This is literally where you can cause two particle systems to fight. Miscellaneous, I did change it. I'm not sure it made much of a difference, but I did set that to 1.5 for each of these, for banking, pitch and height. And then the interesting one, which is the Boid brain. So this is what sets their behavior. So by default, the first thing that they're interested in doing is separating, but then they want to flock, which is why you can see we've got three groups of Boids here, or Boid particles. So I'm going to click here and add a goal brain, as it were, and I'm going to put that at the top. We'll come back to that in a moment. Under flock, I made that. You can use this to move them. The second most important thing that they do, then separate. Then I actually added another one, which is avoid. So if we go back to goal, I'm also now going to add an empty. I'll make it a bit bigger so that it's easier to see. And this empty is going to be moving around eventually, but we'll call that fish target. I'm going to go back to our particle system, and then under goal, with goal selected, I'm going to select in here the fish target. And now you can see they flock towards that target, which currently is just a stationary object. And you can play around with the rule fuzziness. I actually set it up to about 0.8. I'm now going to create a duplicate of that empty. I'm actually going to put it here for the moment. We're going to let that be called fish target 001, which will be a target for a second Boid system. But for my purposes here, I'm going to select the avoid, and we're going to select that fish target 001. So it's not going to necessarily completely block them, but you can obviously play around with how much they're influenced by that here. I also selected predict for this because these are going to be moving, and you can select predict on that one as well. So then we can come down to render and change this to object, and then select our fish, and we'll need to play with the scale a little bit so we can see them. Now your fish may not be swimming in a logical direction. So we can see here they're all swimming sort of sideways. What you may want to do first of all is just apply the mirror modifier, and then we can go into edit mode, rotate X 90. So for me, rotate X 90 and then rotate Y 90 seems to get them all facing in the right direction. And I was doing that in edit mode. You can see my fish source has ended up looking like that. So now they'll swim in a more logical direction. So if I go back to my particle system now, got a reasonable size scale, but we can add some scale randomness now so that they're not all the same size. Could probably have just used object rotation there and it might have fixed the fish, by the way. But you can see it's fine there. They're all swimming logically now. And you will get some interesting little wiggles, which work quite well, I think. If I just turn off the overlay. But we obviously, they're just moving to one position at the moment and then swimming around there. And we obviously want a bit more movement on it than that. So I'm going to open up another window and I'm going to select that empty. I'm going to go to the beginning of the animation and I'm just going to press I and store the location. And then this upper window here, I'll change that to the graph editor. We've still got the empty selected. So if we select, for example, the X location parameter, it's just a straight line at the moment because it's stationary. And then we go to modifiers, add a modifier, and we'll just add some noise. You can see it's just wriggling around a little bit there at the moment. So we'll turn the scale up, and that slows it down, and then turn the strength up, and you can see it's moving a lot more, perhaps a little too much. So if I look from above, you can see it's moving backward and forward. So you may need to bake, which is what I just did, in order to get the fish to notice that their target is moving. And in this case, you may want to also increase the speed that the fish can move at. So I'm just going to select that target now. And we'll turn the strength down a little so it's not moving quite as much. The fish aren't going to notice this change yet. And we'll turn the scale down a little as well. And just randomly change the phase. So I'm now going to copy that and apply it to both the Y and the Z location. But then randomly change the phase for each of those. So that basically they've all got a relatively unique noise pattern on them. We'll go back to our fish. I'm going to delete the bake. I'm going to increase the airspeed a little bit. Go up to say 8. And then we'll bake that. And then we'll see what happens. You can see they're moving more quickly now. You can see some of them get slightly lost. They're being perturbed slightly by that empty that I've said they need to avoid. You can also do the same as we did with the first empty and apply some movement to the axes for this one as well. So again, I'm just going to randomly change the phase, but I'm going to keep the other parameters the same for the moment. So now when I press play, you can see that's moving around as well. Perhaps change that phase bit further. That's it. And then select the particle system or the object with the particle system on it, delete the bake and rebake. And it bakes very quickly at the moment. We will want to set our object here to be not visible. So under render, just turn off show emitter. It'll still be there in previews, but when you actually render, it won't be rendered. That's pretty much all there is to the Boid system, and you can just copy that and create another Boid system. So if I do that, I've created another Boid system over here, but at the moment the targets are the same for both, so they'll tend to sort of be doing similar things. But what I then did for the second system, first of all, you need to come up to the top and click this little 2 so that it's unique, otherwise you'll be just adjusting this, making the same changes to both systems. Then come down here, under the avoid, change that to the fish target, and under the goal, change that to the fish target 001. And now they'll have their own empties, as it were, that they're trying to chase. And you get some more interesting movement there. Just bake that to make sure it's picking up all the changes. So now just very quickly, I will put a link up on the screen on how to get the sort of god ray sun through the surface of the water effect. And the bubbles, that's in a tutorial I did recently. But what I will show you how to do is the weed, the seaweed, whatever you might think it is. So rather than doing a particle system, which I could have done, I decided to just do it with a cloth simulation. So under mesh, I'm going to create a plane. I'm going to rotate it on the X 90, scale Z, and I'm going to scale shift Z there just to make it quite thin, and GZ just to get that origin point at the bottom. Control R, and I'm just going to put some cuts along it like that, and then scale the top there just to bring it in, and perhaps put a cut up the middle as well, and then Control 1 just to add a very low level single level subdivision surface and shade smooth. I'm going to scale on the Z a bit further, and then Control A and apply the scale. Just going to add some more vertices there just to make the bottom more square. And I'm just going to say U unwrap. Going to give it simple material. Go to the shader editor and I'm just going to add texture, which is an image texture. Obviously you can do all sorts of things, but this is just what I did. I have a sort of grass texture that I use here, which has got some interesting shading on it. And we'll put that into the base color. If need be, I can rotate the UV. So rather than the way it's done it automatically, I'm just going to say U, project from view, bounds. And there we go. That's nice and square now. And then because I'll have light shining through it as well as down it, I'm going to add another shader, which is translucent shader. I'm going to add under color gamma node. I'm going to put my texture into the gamma node and then into the translucent. The thinking here is that the color of light coming through the object will be richer and it'll be slightly darker. So I like to add a gamma node and then increase that a little bit. Then I'm going to add under shaders and add shader. So the light that's reflecting off this surface will be added to any light shining through the object, and then just take that into there. So I'll just set the background to a sort of dark bluish color, and we'll add just a basic lamp, an area lamp up there. We'll probably need to turn the brightness of it up quite a bit, but we'll see what it's like. So there's 25 kilowatts. Again, these icospheres will disappear when we do a proper render, and we probably want not too much roughness on that grass blade, as it were, but that's basically the blade created. So now we just need it to behave in a way that looks like it's underwater. So the first thing I did was I added a cloth simulation. But under physics, just click cloth. If I press play now, you'll see it just drops. So we don't want that. What we need to do is go down to the bottom and select at least the bottom three vertices. Come into here, vertex groups, and just click plus and assign. So we've got a group called group that's those bottom few vertices. Come out of edit mode now, go back to the cloth simulation, and then under shape, select the pinning group, which is just the group that we defined. So now if I press play, you can see that it's at least attached there, although it's still dropping down. Next, I came down under field weights to gravity. It's currently set to 1. I'm going to set it to minus 0.25. And now let's see what happens. You can see it doesn't fall. It's not really moving either, but it isn't falling because gravity is obviously working in the opposite direction for this object. And then what I decided to do in order to give a little bit of movement is to add some forces, because forces will affect cloth simulations. So I added under force field a turbulence effect. So I'll just make it bigger so we can see it. And if I press play now, it's not really making much of a difference yet, but let's turn the strength up. And I had it about there, 30 something. You should be able to see that the fish don't get in the way. We're starting to get a little bit of movement on our blade there now. You see it's waving around slightly. I added a little bit of flow and a little bit of noise as well. Seed doesn't matter, you can just set that randomly anywhere. And if you think you need a bit more movement, obviously you can turn the strength up a little bit, and you can even play with the size. So once you're happy with that, we can now make some duplicates. I did it this way because I wasn't going to have lots and lots of seaweed, and I'm changing the size of some of them, and I'll set them quite a bit lower as well, and maybe we'll scale them up a little. So I'll select one of my seaweeds, and then under cache we'll say bake all dynamics. So that'll just make sure both the cloth sim and the particle sims are simulated, and you can see there we've got our seaweed moving around and our fish swimming around between them. So I will share the original file for my Patreon supporters to use for any purpose. And as I said, there will be a link in the description below to the tutorial for creating the water effect with bubbles and god rays flickering through the water, which you can add to this to get the overall effect. I hope you enjoyed that tutorial. If you did, let me know. If you've got any questions, comments, suggestions, I'm very happy to read them, and I always read them in the comments below the video. Otherwise, I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.